Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2338. Extract the trendline formula to the grid. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Gentlin. Today's question sent in by Michel. How can I extract the coefficients from a chart trendline formula to the grid? I'm typing them manually now, but when the inputs change, I have to type them again. All right, this is a great question. First off, what is Michel talking about? So we have a line chart here that's based on that data. If I right-click on the line and say that I want to add a trend line, then over here on the far right-hand side, I can choose which type of trend line: linear, log, polynomial, power, moving average, and I can even forecast into the future. But the one that he's talking about is display the equation on the chart and possibly display the R-squared value on the chart. Seeing back here in the chart, we get this nice little text box, but it's just a text box. How do we extract those numbers into the grid? Now, there's two different answers to this depending on whether you have dynamic arrays or not. Dynamic arrays, by the way, just last week, July 2020, were released to the general population of Microsoft 365 subscribers. So, great feature that we've had on Insiders for over a year, but now has reached a lot more people. Here's how you can tell if you have it. Just come out here and type equals sequence. Just choose a number 5. If you get an answer, then you have dynamic arrays. If you don't, if you get a name error, then you're going to have to do the harder steps. So with dynamic arrays, equal LINEST. What do you call that? Do you call that LINEST? Or do you call it LINEST? My friend Claire calls it LINEST. I always called it LINEST. I don't know. Down in the YouTube comments, let me know how you actually pronounce that function. It stands for the straight line regression, basically. So it asks for the known y's. The y values is the height of the line. So that's B2 to B41. And then the known x's, A2 to A41. And then is the intercept forced to be 0? You want to say true there, so it's calculated normally. It doesn't have to be 0. And then most important, get all of the additional regression statistics. So a second true. So point to the y's, point to the x's, true, true. All right, and it returns 5 rows, 2 columns. And you'll see that so this is y equals mx plus b. The b, the y-intercept, is there in the second column, first row. The m value, the slope, the 27.117, is there in D2, and the r squared is down here in row 3, column 1. These other statistics, I have those in a book, but I don't have them memorized. I'd have to go pull the book out to tell you what those are. All right, now if you do have to do this without dynamic arrays, it's pretty weird. You have to select the 5 rows, 2 columns, select that whole range, type the formula, but don't press Enter. Instead, hold down Control and Shift and then press Enter. That gets you a old-fashioned array formula wrapped in the curly braces like that. All right, there you go. Well, I want to thank Michelle for sending that question in. If you enjoy these videos, please subscribe down below and ring that bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments in the comments below. My new book, Mr. Excel 2020, click that I in the top right-hand corner. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.